Hi, hello law aspirants. So, my erudite, learned, scholar, scintillating, somebody who is knowledgeable and cerebral, historic, sapient, scholars, genius, wonderful people, cogent and scintillating, who are grasping more and more knowledge and being cerebral. Yes, I hope you are doing wonderful in your English. Yes, this erudite and this learned skill, this knowledge is really going to help you, because if you're knowledgeable, nobody can beat you in your task. Yes, let's begin with our roots for today. I promised you new roots, so none of the roots is repeated. Stay tuned, we'll be coming up with wonderful roots, so many roots that you'll really feel English is, yes, child's play for you, right? Okay, let's begin with today's task. I've jotted down so many roots for you, and this is a wonderful root, that is lie. The word lig is something which means a tie or a bind, something which joins, right? That is the word here, that is lie. Now, when I take this tie or bind, it means you are bound or you're confined to something. It's an obligation, condition of being tied to, joined. You are obliged or tied to something. You are tied back to one's See, when I say I'm obliged to do it, means I'm bound to. You've heard this word, hands tied. My hands are tied. Have you heard of this? Or I'm bound to do something. Or the word like can't help. See, one of the grammar rules specially to be followed in this, can't help is followed by verb ing, which is called a gerund in English, a noun which does the role of verb. Yes, so you find so many words where you are sometimes stuck, you don't have a choice, you are supposed to do that thing again and again. So the word click, obligation, condition of being tied to or obliged, you're tied to something, you're bound to do something. These words are really going to be a helping hand for you. Religious, tying back to one's origin, from where one's culture, in fact one's traditions, I would say, or if I would add up here, that is one's culture. The activity of tying back to one's origin, it's been repeated because this is religious, he is religious, and religion is a noun. See this, and this is an adjective. Parts of speech, grammar, vocabulary, idioms, synonyms, antonyms, they go hand in hand. Yes, it's an amalgamation of knowledge. So the word next, I'm obliging, you're obliging thing, trying to help someone, moving towards someone, that is being very obliging. Ligament is a tissue band which ties bones together. You know, our ligament has to be, you know, tied together so that the things, the movement is smooth. Band of tissues which ties bones together, binds organs in place, that is a ligament, right? Okay, let's move to the words further. I hope you have noted down the root. Very interesting root. Try to join to it. Please be bound to it so that you can understand them. Next word, allegiance, allied or alliance. You can see this? Yes, joined together. So that's why I want to add up here with this root, not only L-E-I-G, but with this we also add up, that is L-E-G. So that there is no problem the student face while doing the root. And there isn't any problem that exists. Let's move to the part of this in the next scenario. The word allegiance is a condition of being tied to a specific cause or team. You're joined with any team. That is the word allegiance. The word rely means you depend on something, right? Depend on. Please note the phrasal verbs for this. Bank on. Count on. You can count on me, you can depend on me, you can bank on me, or you can rely on me. See the preposition usage on, a very important usage. Understand the usage in the proper, thorough manner. You're tied back to something. He's a very reliable person. That means capable of being tied back to. This person you can fully trust. He is, in fact, what would we write the word? Yes, trustworthy. He can become your confidant from the root co and fid. That would be confidant. So, he is very confidant of yours. Now, when we have the other words and other words in this part, that's the next word, ally, one to whom you tie yourself, you feel you're joined, you're bound with something. Alliance, it's a kind of a condition of being tied to someone, it's a kind of a treaty. It's a kind of a union. It may be a conspiracy in the negative sense. Anything where you have an alliance with any party, you join hands, right? Next word, liaison. Liaison is one who creates social and business ties between organization. The social ties are tied by this person, and that is liaison. Liable, you know, you have a liability towards something, means you are an answerable to. You are capable of being tied to. You are answerable to, you have an account for. You have to account for your sins. Means you are answerable for whatever action that you do, that you are liable to. Right? I hope you have understood the word. You have noted down all the words linked with this, the subsidiary roots along with this. Okay. Let's begin with next. Next word, next root, sect. Sect is cut or divide something. You make a kind of a division. So that is why we will take up the meaning along with this, that is divide. Insect is a creature which is cut into three parts, cut into three. You can see one thing very carefully, the use of the preposition into with cut or divide. Why? See, the word into is used for movement and entrance. That means change of state or condition. The condition of something changes, that is the state of change or condition, that is into. He jumped into, divide into, cut into, put into, you know. This means you are making a change of state. One thing which was united, you divided. So you can see the change of state in this. You cut into two parts, three parts, whatever number of parts. But you had made one united thing into divided. You got my point, right? So, she walked into the room means she was outside, she came into. It's a very interesting usage. Do make up 10 sentences of into and do write me. Segment. Again, word we have is S-E-G. So, let's again join up with the root. S-E-G with S-E-C-T, that is to cut or divide something. Segment or segmentation is cutting into small pieces. You know, in simple words, it means chopping or to mince. The class was divided in different segments. India has various segments, but still it is a united country. Right? Bisect. Now see the root which works in this. Bi means, yes, two. So bisect means you cut or divide it exactly into two. Intersect, from the root next, inter is equal to in between. So intersect would be cut in between, right? Or intersection is cutting between. Second is a straight line that cuts across a curve at two or more points. There's a straight line. This is a straight line and you cut across and that's a curve in it. That would be a word like second, right? Okay. Let's move further in more words of this. You've understood, I hope, with the word S-E-C-T or S-E-G in the sense of yes, cut or divide. Dissection. Being a science student in the 11th when I had opted for it, I did understand there was a dissection of frog. It really was something so awful and a terrible experience for me. It was an awe-inspiring one. So, dissection is the act of cutting into two parts, cutting apart. Dai is two and sec is cut. So, cut into two parts, that is dissection. Veni section from the root ven is veins. So, cutting the veins of something. Dissected is really you have cut apart and made two pieces out of it. And I am talking of a section. The section means part of the whole. Okay? A small group. A cluster. Not whole. Like when I am talking of a, this kind of thing, I am talking of like 1/4 people do this. So, this is 25%. Most of the students are hardworking, 75%. But 25 do nothing. That is, this section, this part needs to really work hard. See, exams are approaching. Pull up your socks, work in the full swing. Things would be accessible. Passage is nothing. Not a problem for those students who really work hard. So, please put in your best. It's this the one important, most important thing in fact required from you. Yes? Okay. Moving to our next root. See, we have done the root LIG, that is tie or bind. We have taken up the next root, that is sec, that is cut. I have added up in this, that is SEG, because that also means cut to divide. And I'm turning to the next root, that is stat. Stat means stands, something which is firm, something which is not moving, something which cannot be deterred from the path, something which is stagnant. Yes. So the word stat, wonderful usage of this root, stat. Stat means station. Now station means you standing at a place, you're not moving, you're not mobile, you are in a stationary state. Or you are static, right? So, when you're standing at a place, one place, a fixed place, in fact, you are not mobile, not movement or mobile state, then we use the word, he was stationary. Next word, status. One standing, where do you stand socially? Which caste, community, race and your social, do you belong to the cream of the society, the elite class, the sophisticated class as lawyers are? And what is your status, higher status, lower status? These things are something which tells you your stand, your position in society. Stature, one, how tall one stands or one's societal standing. Your stature is your position about something, right? Statue. Statue is an image of a standing thing. It could be a real one, it could be a copied one, it could be a portrait, it could be anything, but it is a standing image of something. Statement is how, saying how something stands. What is the usage? How does it work? What is the usage of that statement? Is statement. State, now I state this, like see it's a verb, I state this, now see the usage, it's a part of speech, that is verb. State can be used also as a noun or you could use it the word statement of teachers. You can see the noun usage. So, in fact, what you have to remember, that is that we have stat, which means that is something that stands, something which is static, something which is stationary. See, there are the words which may be confusing for you. They have more words in this. I'll have some 10 to 15 words with the root stat. So, I'll continue the next section in the next class tomorrow with the more words with the word root stat, right? So, please, I hope you liked all the new roots. Do write your examples, jot down the things that are interconnected with it. All your problems are most welcome, and do like and subscribe the channel. Right, students? Thank you.